虽然 Joe Biden 和习近平两个人展开了3个小时的视讯对话，但是美国还是基于对于维吾尔等人权议题背个北京的冬季奥运，这个并没有出现在2008年的北京奥运。2008年的时候，不只是没有背个美国的运动员参加，美国总统小布希亲自出席在鸟巢的北京奥运，所以你可以看到双方关系呢，在13年之后急速的转为恶化的情况。而美国所重启的印太战略，现在就从军事走向经济，最新的就是希望能够推动印太地区的经济框架。我刚刚特别提到，在美国和中国在整体亚洲霸权的冲突当中，台湾过去这一段时间一直被推上第一火线，事实上现在正有第二个即将浮现上来。这个在2013年本来它是当主角的，但是他因为换掉了总统，他变成了配角。这个国家叫菲律宾，菲律宾在那个时代代表美国在海牙法庭里头打起了南海主权的仲裁官司，中国方面被认为输掉了。在这个情况里头，中国群情激愤，而中国的外交战略的方法，一方面驳斥了南海仲裁，另外一方面直接就介入了整个在菲律宾内部的游说，最后他支持也押宝正确了杜特地。从杜特地当选之后，菲律宾就不是一个完全亲美的政权，他时而倾向中国，时而倾向美国，双方各自得到他要得到的好处。杜特地连任2届之后，依照宪法他不可以再连任了。最新他支持的是他的女儿当副总统，而郑总统是上次大家还记得1985年被菲律宾的 People's Party 推翻的当时的马可士他的儿子。那当然这个在菲律宾的所有的人都在看到底是谁会当选。那除了国内议题之外，最重要的一件事情是将来的当选者是重新回到亲美吗？那菲律宾又会成为美国在印太尤其是南海战略里头，因为它的地理位置是美国打南海主权最好的一个盟邦，那这个时刻菲律宾又成为美中另外一个最重要的热战地点。那如果最后当选还是跟杜特地有关的延续的势力，它的整个立场又是一会儿亲中一会儿亲美，那么某程度来说这场选举本身是美中的代理人战争里头非常重要的一场选举，它不只是菲律宾人民的选举。
My orders are sa police pati military. Buhay ninyo ay nalagay sa alanganin. Shoot them dead.
2016年5月，受够了贪腐无能政客的菲律宾人选出了一位非典型总统。他竞选时夸下海口要杀光菲律宾毒贩。
If I make it to the president, I will do just what I did. Papatayin kita.
他说到做到。
According to the government's own account, more than 5,600 citizens have been killed by the police over the last 4 years. Taking into account drug-related killings carried out by unidentified vigilantes.The number of victims rises to 16,355.
菲律宾宪法规定，总统任期6年不得连任，转眼6年任期将至，安静的转身离开，不是杜特地的风格。面对明年的选战，76岁的杜特地一会儿喊要退出政坛，一会儿说要拱女儿上位，怎奈在总统人选民调第一的女儿和他一样不按牌理出牌。
The unpredictable political landscape in the Philippines, shaken by last-minute announcements from the family of outgoing President Rodrigo Duterte. He's constitutionally barred from running for a second presidential term. His daughter Sarah filed for candidacy for vice president, Briefly, the elder Duterte threatened to also run for the same job, until he backtracked from competing against his daughter, instead announcing a last-minute bid to become senator.
总统大选2022年5月才会登场，已知的主角有
a professional boxer, the son of a notorious dictator, and a city mayor who once starred in steamy movies.
It's official.Bongbong Marcos and Sara Duterte will run as a tandem in the 2022 elections.
这位小马可是是谁呢
？A frontrunner in the current polls, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. His father declared martial law, ruling the Philippines with a terrible human rights record until a popular uprising ousted him in 1986. His mother Imelda, still famous for her shoes.
在马可仕垮台三十年后，杜特地这位另类强人崛起，同样在人权上劣迹斑斑。然而，他的支持者看似并不介意。
Merry Christmas, kayo mga drugista, magdanakaw, mga korap, mga kriminal, at yung napapahirap sa Pilipino. Kaya kung ayaw ninyong minto at patuloy pa rin ang karasan, ito na ang huli ninyong Merry Christmas.
有民意当后盾，对于联合国要求菲律宾政府采取行动，减少杀人及法外处决，他是这么说的。
You will be excluded in the UN. You deport, you go and go ahead. You are interfering in our affairs.
对提出关切的美国讲的话就。更难听了。
I am a president of a sovereign state, and we have long ceased to be a colony. I do not have any master except the Filipino people. Putang ina, mumurahin kita dyan sa
son of a bitch. I'll curse you in front of everybody.
Mr. Obama, you can go to hell.
Duterte's shakeup goes beyond domestic politics. He has also put his stamp.On Philippine foreign policy.
We feel that it's time for us to be able to have these relationships that are meaningful, that we can deal with the world on our own. And while we value our relationship with the United States, we also feel that it's time for us to look into the other countries to be able to deal with them.
I've seen America, and it's lousy.
Eager to reduce the Philippines' dependence on the U.S., Duterte has turned enthusiastically to China.
I announce my separation from the United States.
In terms of South China Sea, Duterte government is not, in the Chinese perception, making trouble with China on the South China Sea. In terms of the overall attitude towards China, Duterte government is also extremely pro-China and regarded as friendly power compared to the previous Aquino III administration.
正是他提起南海仲裁案。在奥巴马时代，美国借着南海议题拉拢东南亚国家对抗中国。2016年7月12号，海牙常设仲裁法院宣布，中国声称拥有南海主权的九段线地图没有法律依据。但是此时，菲律宾已换上杜特地执政，他淡化南海争议，还亲自宣布愿意和大陆合作探勘南海石油。
We do not want war with China. China is a good friend.
当2017年 ISIS 战士在马拉维作乱，在战事陷入焦灼之际，北京第一时间送去价值5000万人民币的3000支枪与600万发子弹。
Some experts have urged Western countries to scale back military aid that is facilitating Duterte's drug war.Others worry that any cutbacks could drive the Philippines further into the arms of the Chinese.
Oh, for heaven's sakes, it drives me crazy when I hear assertions like that because, you know, we forget we're treaty allies. The fact that the Filipinos give us a privileged treaty position is good for our defense. We're not doing the Philippines a favor. We're doing ourselves a favor. Our ability to operate near, in conjunction with the Philippines is good for America.
即使夹在美中大国之间，杜特地也没有让菲律宾成为大国博弈的牺牲品。